o ya ta chi ru ka ga ta shi de le ta ni tri nga zo yo ane o man ju pa to ni sa ra ma de ta ta chi chi fu lo ka chi to ni ka chi mo ane de shi de ya ka dis gu gre ka dis so no to gu gre lo ju ka dis che gu gre shi ni ta ka ze ta da ma de se de shi ja gi is.
So then, hello, Tashi Deli, to all of my Dharma friends. So today, based upon a verse from the text of Entering the Middle Way or the Madhyamaka-vatara, I will explain some important things, how to develop a happy mind, how to study, how to practice, and so forth.
ওটা পাদি দাওয়া ড্রপ আছে না কাজ গমানি দেশে যা ছাব পাছি দেশে যা ছাবাস ওটা সুঞ্জি গ লোট নুনিলা তাছে তোজন দাও তাওয়া সুঞ্জি গ গুমা নেনে পগে রাকি হা কসরাওয়া ওটা তন্ডি গলামা সাচি মুশিরে দিয়ারেস.
So I mentioned the glorious Chandrakirti a little bit before. So this great Indian pundit, he can be regarded as one of the main followers of the Buddha. And in addition, he was somebody who was really able to understand the philosophical view of the Buddha, really able to determine the Buddha's intent. And so in terms of all of the different scriptures of Buddhism, we could say that this Madhyamaka-vatara, or the Entering the Middle Way, is one of the most pristine and one of the most important of all of the scriptures. So whether we talk about the Buddhist teachings on the science of the mind, whether we talk about the Buddhist teachings of the philosophical view, we could say that this text of the Madhyamaka-vatara, Entering the Middle Way, is expressing the very highest understanding. So in terms of the actual mode of abiding of objects, that means the way that things really are, or the way that things really exist, this was expressing those, this text was expressing those in the very best understanding. So what are we saying connected with this today? The text is speaking about somebody who really wishes for both temporary and ultimate happiness. If we are somebody who is really wishing for temporary and ultimate happiness, both of those, and we don't want suffering, then what we need to do is we need to leave samsara behind. We need to leave samsara behind and travel to the other shore.
Oda tiri tsi laya tingi na tsi nyembo kod dewo hako sarwa tsi da meni pake netsi tezi shiba zonji ngine yile dewan yuwan rawo tindigi netsi chiten de yuwa res.
So in terms of the words I'm going to share with you from this verse by Chandrakirti today, these are very beautiful words. These are words that are easy to understand. And they're also words that even if you develop just a little bit of a comprehension of them, a special happiness will arise within the mind.
ওটা সঙ্গে রমচি ওতি হ্যাঁ পিকা ইয়া কালো নো বিকাল চিয়া চোন চোর তিছি দে পেছে তোনে লঙ্গা রসলমা দেজে মম বচা গিয়া রে
সো
মিমে সঙ্গে রমচি ইনা ইয়ো তান্দা শুলো কাচি দে মা দেজে জান লঙ্গা রসলবা কালো মম বতু গিয়া রে.
And so this particular verse as well, this verse from Chandrakirti, is something that His Holiness the Dalai Lama, when there are gatherings, he also mentions this verse and teaches from this verse.
ওটা চো চো তঙ্গি আলমে চি দে মা সি ও চি চি তে তনে ইং আনজো দে জানা অনে জি ইং আনজো সুতু জে কাঙ্গাল তনে পাশা জায় ইন রে শলা জু ইন রে ওটা তেন দে জে মব ইয়ারেস.
So as I read this, I will read the shloka or the verse, and then this is something that is both beneficial for myself and others in terms of being able to get a beneficial imprint in the mind, in terms of being able to have the blessing of the text in the mind. So Geshe-la is reading the shloka or the verse from Chandrakirti's Entering the Middle Way, the Madhyamaka-vatara. So I will share this with you in English. Spreading his wings of relative and ultimate truth, leading the swans of individuals, this king of swans soars ahead on the strong winds of virtue and proceeds to the supreme far shore of the victorious one's qualities. So these are beautiful words that use an example as a way to bring forth an easy understanding for us. So what is this example saying in the verse? The verse is telling us that samsara, or cyclic existence, is like an ocean. It is something that is very deep and vast, and also something that is unknown and full of many dangers or obstacles. So the verse is telling us that this ocean, which is samsara, it is vast and deep, but there is the king of birds, the swan, who on the basis of his very vast wings, on the basis of his or her two vast wings, can travel across that ocean happily, playfully, to the shore which is free from samsara, from cyclic existence. The swan can travel happily across the water to that other shore because the beautiful sun is shining for warmth on his back and the breeze from the water is cooling his belly. So, like that, if we want real happiness, stable happiness, if we want the temporary and ultimate happiness that is inexhaustible and everlasting, So if we want that kind of happiness and we want to be able to complete this journey just like the king of birds, the swan, what do we need to do? There are two paths that we need to cultivate, and those paths are the path of perfect method and the path of perfect wisdom. So if we are able to do that, to apply the practices of method and wisdom by studying them and training in hearing, contemplation, and meditation, both analytical and placement meditation, then like that swan, even while in samsara, we will be able to fly happily across that ocean, all the while traveling to that destination of ultimate happiness. So happy in the journey and happy in the destination. So while traveling across that ocean, of course, there will be some obstacles, but because we have those two practices of method and wisdom, we'll be able to protect our mind from those obstacles. And then, once we reach our destination, that other shore apart from samsara, the obstacles will be completely cleared away.
So
And so what are these two wings that we are talking about? They are the wing of the method practice, so bodhicitta, the aspiration for enlightenment rooted in love and compassion, and the wing of wisdom, wisdom realizing emptiness, which is perfected because of the enhancement of that bodhicitta. And also another thing that I want to share here is that in terms of this method and wisdom, if we say the study and practice of method and wisdom, it will take a long time to experience the results, the happiness from that. I would say that this is incorrect because as soon as we begin thinking about method and wisdom, as soon as this enters the mind, immediately there is some happiness. And immediately we begin engaging in the process of accumulating those causes of happiness. So then, of course, in terms of the wisdom realizing emptiness, there may be some people who think that, oh, this is something that is a very difficult. This is something that I can't engage in right away. This is definitely possible. So we can look at this in that way, in that if we talk about wisdom realizing emptiness to get the actual realization of the valid cognition of that, this is something that takes study and practice over a long period of time. However, in terms of being able to experience feelings of happiness right away from this practice, if we think about emptiness just a little bit, already we will be able to experience results of happiness within the mind. So let me give an example of how these teachings on emptiness can be practical right now. When we encounter an object, for example, a person, and that object gives rise to our anger, or gives rise to our attachment, or indeed any of the afflictions, such as pride, jealousy, and so forth, what we can do is we can immediately think, we can use our understanding of emptiness to think, that object which is giving rise to that attachment or anger, for example, it does not exist in the way that it appears. So that object of our anger and similarly that object of our attachment, they do not exist in the way that they appear. And if we understand that, if we have just that awareness that they don't exist in the way that they appear, then the type of doubt, nervousness, stress that enters our mind, for example, we can understand that that too, that unpleasant feeling, is arising from something that does not exist in the way that it appears. So it's very important when we first encounter that object that gives rise to our attachment or aversion that we use our intelligence to examine that and see if that object is really existing in the way that it appears. And similarly, in terms of the inner experience of that unpleasant feeling of the anger or the aversion, for example, we have to see if that is also existing in the way that it feels or appears. So if we think of emptiness using easy examples and we think of it in that way, then it is definitely something that we can immediately make use of in our life.
타이노 가시에 그때가 소소 그냥 가르쳐가 로조데 때문에 원래 제니 좀 어두만이 있으면 배도 매 노거래 나오냐 노아샤가 요할 때 말했어. 아 시랍 다 앞에서 소바 제가 이거 로또 이제 요아레스 어느 쇼마도 이제 거는 배도 요아르다 배도 느린들이제 자 다 앞에서 소바 되게 대지제 요아레스
So somebody might say that ultimate truth, the study and practice of the teachings on emptiness, this just means that there's nothing there at all. This vision of kind of nothingness appears. But of course, that is not really the meaning of wisdom. We understand that this is not the case because relative truth is still there along with the ultimate truth. And the relative truth speaks about the reality of self and others and so forth. And so because of those relative truths, then we definitely need to cultivate love. We definitely need to cultivate compassion and so forth.
어 다당 알아서 소소소 예예 자체 뭐 간지 지연에 대로 좀 봐도 이제 여봐 놓지 어 소소 돌 간지 이제 여봐 이나에 대봐마 대네 대네 소소 그거 뭐 시봐 근데 제가 봐 자체 자체 너나 아까 사람 어 단 니가 느끼 봐 다 들 느끼 봐 너서 된대 말해
So if in terms of the relative truth, the method side of the path, if we think of the love and compassion we have for those people that are close to us, our friends and our family, we try to gradually extend that sphere of love and compassion so that it encompasses other people, also people unknown to us, and even beyond that. And then in this way, as we increase that sphere of love and compassion, we are able to experience more temporary and ultimate happiness. So if we are able to really increase the sphere of love and compassion, like I mentioned, then whatever human we encounter, indeed whatever animal or sentient being we encounter, we will have the feeling that they are unbearably close to us, that they are our friend. And with that kind of vision, we will not have the conception of any enemy. And imagine the happiness that that leads to.
어다 당게 또만이 또 비시라 되게 될로 봐 첨부 제기와래 세야본 것도 시소나 드니네서 통화 잘 하고 살아와
So understanding this closeness of all beings to us, this is the relative truth that greatly enhances the ultimate truth of wisdom realizing emptiness.
어다 드니네서 드니네 타 벌써 또 봐 시라 벌써 또 봐 대 드와 시바라 메 첨부 그것만도 빼녀 첨부 그것만도 소소 놀을 해래 지는 거가 가지라 봐이나 소소 라발
And in terms of these practices of method and wisdom, these are not things that we need great wealth, influence, or fame to be able to practice. These are things that we can just give rise to when we are at home, that anybody can do. The responsibility is in our hands.
Oh, ta ngaro so lama so ina yichi bari ngaro so kanga chi bari wa so so chi bol debi ka koka kaze ra ba ina yikir kiri no yaji ma to on nyoya tieni yo amare.
So if we understand all of the things that we have to practice, then like the great lamas say, when we are alone, we won't be bored or anything. We'll have more and more of these things to apply and we'll become happier and happier.
Oh, ta ngaro so kanga kandi chi ina yi neyo la so ba do. Da koi nyo da kandi chi ina yi teni so no to na.
And if we understand the possibilities of these practices, then we can understand that any of the problems that manifest, whether illness or the other problems of samsara, these can definitely be solved through the actualization of the teachings.
So understanding
the value of these teachings, then whenever you have a free time, then engage in the practice of the hearing, contemplation, and meditation on these topics as the cause of happiness. Thanks very much. We'll end it here.